Good afternoon all. Welcome to the lecture on discrete mathematical structure. Okay, screen is visible. So in last lecture we have completed our third unit, which is nothing but the relation and functions. Okay, now today we will start the last unit, which is nothing but the mathematical logic. Actually, mathematical logic we have already studied in 12th class. Okay, that is we have to the mathematical logic. Okay, that is we have to study the conjunction, disjunctions, what is the statement, what is the truth value. These concepts we have to study. First we will see what is a statement. Okay, a statement is a declarative sentence. A statement is a declarative sentence which is either true or false, but not both. Okay, so what is a statement? It is one statement which declares something. Okay, that is, suppose there is one statement, that is Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. This sentence will be a one statement, since it declares that the Mumbai will be a capital of our Maharashtra. Okay, so such as sentences, such as declarative sentences are called the statements. And such statements are either true or false, but not both simultaneously. That is, Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. It is a true. If, for example, if we take Jaipur is the capital of Maharashtra, this one will be false. But one particular statement will be not true and false at a time. Okay, that is here we have given. So a statement is a declarative statement which is either true or false, but not both simultaneously. And the statement is are denoted by this small letter. That is P, Q, R, whatever it will be. Okay, and statements are denoted by P, Q, R, S, whatever it will be. Okay, now the next concept will be the truth value of the statement. Truth value of the statement. Each statement is either true or false. Okay, if it is true, then its truth value it's capital T, and if it is false, then its truth value is F. Truth value is capital F. Okay, so if we take any statement, then it will be either a true statement or a false statement. If it is a true statement, then its truth value is denoted by capital T. And if it is a false statement, then its truth value is denoted by capital A. Now we will see some examples of statements and some examples of sentences which are not the statements. Okay, now. The following sentences sentences are statements. Okay, in that first one, sun rises in the east. Okay, this will be a statement and it will be a true. Second one, 5 × 2 will be equal to 11. 5 × 2 will be equal to 11. Actually, 5 × 2 will be equal to 10. But here we have given a statement, 5 × 2 will be equal to 11. It is a statement, but it is not a true statement. It will be a false statement. Therefore, its truth value will be F. Now, third one. For general example, Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. Again, it is a true statement, therefore its truth value will be T. Now, see some examples which are not these statements. Following sentences are not statements. First one. What are you doing? This one will be a not a statement. Since statement, by definition of statement is nothing but it is a declarative statement, sentence which is either true or false. But here the given sentence is nothing but what are you doing. Actually, it is a asking something. Okay, therefore it will be not a statement. Second one, please give your pay. This one will be again or something. It is something. It will be like a order, that is, please give me your pay. Again, it will be not a statement. Similarly, what is your name? This will be again not a statement. What is your name? So such sentences are not the statements. Okay. Now there is one note. Interrogatory or interrogative exclamatory command order request and a suggestion are not the statements. Okay, so the sentences which are interrogative, exclamatory, command, order, request and suggestion, that is, if we our sentence in which there will be a request or there is a suggestion or we can order something, that is, these type of sentences are not the statements. Since for statement we have to take a declarative sentence which will be either true or false, whatever it will be, but it will be give some declaration about something. Such type of sentences are called the statements. But if we have giving some order in that sentence, or we will request, or there is a suggestion, then such type of sentences are not the statements. Okay, now we will see some examples of such type of sentences. Consider the following. First one, 3x divided by 2 minus of 9 is equal to 0. Second one, mathematics is an interesting subject. And third one, it is black in color. Okay, Now these are the some sentences. Now here 3x divided by 2 minus 9 will be equal to 0. After solving here we get x equal to 6. If we take x equal to 6, then 6 into 3 will be 18. 18 divided by 2, 9. 9 minus 9 will be equal to 0. So if x equal to 2, then this will be 2. First one. If x is equal to 6, then 3x upon 2 minus 9 is equal to 18 divided by 2 minus 9, that is 9 minus 9, and which is equal to 0. So if x equal to 6, then it is true. But if x is not equal to 6, then given sentence is not true. Then given sentence is not true. Therefore, here we get a sentence in which this particular sentence is both true and false for some particular values. Then by the definition of statement, it is not a statement. Similarly for 2 and 3. These are the concepts which are changed by person by person. That is, for some people's mathematics will be an interesting subject, for some people some people don't like mathematics, therefore it will be changes from person to person. Similarly, it is black in color, it is again changes from person to person. So 2 and 3 changes from person to person. Person to person. Okay, so these are the not the same statements, since they are depending on some particular situations. Since if x is equal to 6, then first will be true, and if we collect all those people who like the mathematics, then second one will be also true. And if we again collect some particular things they which are black in color, then again they will it will be true. So these three sentences are depending on some particular situations. They are always not true and always not false. Therefore, such type of sentences are not the statements, and such type of sentences are called the open sentences, and these open sentences are never the statements. Okay. These are the examples of open sentences. Open sentences, and they are not the statement. Statements. Okay. Now there will be one example. Which of the following sentences, are statements in logic? Write down the truth value, of the statements. First, we have to examine whether the corresponding sentences are the statements, and if they are statements, then we have to find out its truth values. First one. 6 into 4 will be equal to 25. Second one, x plus 6 equal to 9. Third one, every real number is a complex number. Every real number is a complex number. Now we have to solve this one. The solution. Now first one, here 6 into 4 is equal to 25, that is the LHS of this sentence declares something, that is 6 into 4 have some value 25. Now we have to check whether it is true or false, but it will be a statement. Since 6 into 4 will be equal to 25, it declares something. Okay, now by the definition of statement, it is a statement. But as 6 into 4 will be equal to 24, but here given that 6 into 4 will be 25, therefore it is a false statement. 6 into 4 equal to 25 is a statement which is false. Which is false. Hence, its truth value is its truth value is capital M. Okay. Now, similarly, second law. Here again, we get x plus 6 equal to 9. X plus 6 equal to 9. If x is equal to 3, then it will be 3 plus 6, and which is equal to 9. For x equal to 3, it is 2. But if we take x is any number which is other than 3, then it is not a statement. Okay, since this will be of the form open sentence, x plus 6 equal to 9 is a open sentence. Plus 6 equal to 9 is a open sentence, and we know that open sentences are not the statements. As it is not a sentence, then it have no truth value. So it is not a statement. Now third one. Every real number is a complex number. Real numbers are of the form, it contains all the rational and irrational numbers. And complex number are of the form, it contains all numbers of the form a plus ib, which here a and b belonging to capital R. So by the definition of real number and definition of real number and complex number, each real number is a complex number. Therefore, it is a statement and which is true. Which is true, then its truth value is its truth value is capital. So in this way we have to first check whether the given sentences are the statements, and if they are statements, then we have to find out its truth value. Okay, Kunal, kahi doubt yamadhe?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, the next concepts are logical connectives . Okay, see the definition of logical connective. If the words or axes which can be used to connect two statements are called logical connectives. Okay, so the words or the verses which are used to connect the two statements are called logical connective. That is, we can use some words, or that is काही शब्द किंवा वाक्य जे की आपण यूज करणार आहे दोन स्टेटमेंट एकत्र करणार तशा शब्दांना किंवा वाक्यांना आपण काय म्हणणार आहे लॉजिकल कनेक्टिव्ह. हियर वी स्टडी द कनेक्टिव्ह अँड सेकंड वन और थर्ड वन. If then fourth one, if and only if and only if, and last one will be a not. Okay, so here we study the logical connectives, which are and, or, if, then, if and only if, not. Since these are the words which can be used to connect the two or more than two statements. Okay. Now, next concept, which is a simple and compound statements. Simple and compound statements. If a statement which cannot split into further into two or more statements is called a simple statement. And a statement which is a combination of two or more statements is called compound statement. Okay, so what is a simple statement and a compound statement? If any statement which cannot be split into two or more statement is called a simple statement, and if a statement will be particular statement will be a combination of two or more than two statement, then such a statements are called the compound statement. For example, first one, 3 is odd and 4 is even number is a compound statement. Since in this statement there are two different statements, that is 3 is odd, it will be one statement, 4 is even number, it will be a second statement, therefore this will be a statement which is a combination of two statements, hence it is a compound statement. And second one is 3 and 5 are odd natural numbers. Okay, so it will be a simple statement, since in this statement there is only one condition, that is both the integers 3 and 5 are the two odd natural numbers. Okay, so this type of examples we have to examine, whether it will be a simple statement or it will be a compound statement. Now let us study some connectives. First will be a AND connective, that is AND connective is also called as a conjunction. Okay, now first will be a conjunction. If two statements are combined using the connective and then it is called as conjunction. Okay, so if suppose we have two statements, if they are combined by using a connective which is AND, then it is called as a conjunction. In other words, if P and Q are two word statements, then P and Q is called a conjunction, and it is denoted by P and Q, that is this will be a symbol, okay, which is called AND symbol. So if P conjunction Q is denoted by this symbol, that is P and Q, and read as P conjunction Q or P and Q. okay, and the conjunction, the conjunction or P and Q, that is P and Q, is true if and only if, and only if both P and Q are true. P and Q are true. Okay. So what is the statement? Is state, conjunction. If two statements are combined using the connective and, then it is called as a conjunction. For example, if suppose we have two statements P and Q, then P and Q is called the conjunction, and it is denoted by this symbol, that is P and Q, and which is read as P conjunction Q or P and Q. And the conjunction, that is if two statement, we have two statements, then P and Q or P conjunction true, P conjunction Q is true if and only both the statements P and true, then only the corresponding P and Q or P conjunction Q will be true. Otherwise, it will be always false. Now let us see the truth table for the conjunction. Truth table for conjunction. Okay. Now, in first column, we will take P, statement P. In second one, we will take Q. And in third one, we have to take the P conjunction Q. Now, in P, we will take, already we have studied this concept in 12. That is, we have to take TTFF. And in Q, we have to take, since P has two possibilities, that is either true or false. Secondly, Q has again two possibilities, either it is true or false. Then combining these two, there are four possibilities. P is true, similarly P is true, similarly Q is true. P is true but Q is false. P is false, Q is true. P is false, Q is false. These are the possibilities of combining two statements P and Q. Since each statement P and Q has two possibilities, P has two possibilities, that is true and false. Similarly, Q has again two possibilities, either it is true or false. So combining these two possibilities of P and Q, we get the four possibilities. That is, there are four possibilities. In first possibility, both P and Q are true. In second one, P is true but Q is false. In third one, P is false, Q is true. And in fourth one, both are the false. Now, by the definition of conjunction, P and Q or P conjunction Q is true if and only both P and Q are true. So in first cases, both P and Q are true, then its truth value will be. Now in second one, P is true but Q is false, but by the definition of P conjunction Q is true if and only both are true, but here Q is false, then its truth value is false. Again in second one, P is false and Q is true, again it is F. In second one, both are F, therefore it is again F. So this will be a truth table for the conjunction. Okay, any doubt?
No sir.
Okay, now the second one will be a disjunction. If two statements are combined, using the logical connective or then it is called disjunction in particular, or in other words, that is if two statements are combined by using the connectivity or, that is in two statements we have to use the word or, then such type of compound statement will be called as a disjunction. In other words, if P and Q are two statements, then P or Q is called disjunction, and it is denoted by P disjunction Q. So disjunction is denoted by this symbol. And read as predisjunction Q. P disjunction Q or P or Q. Okay. So disjunction is denoted by this symbol and it will be written read as P disjunction Q or P or Q. Okay. So these are the two ways to read PP. And disjunction P or Q or P disjunction Q is false if and only if P and Q both are false. Both are false. Okay. So the disjunction statement, that is, it will be a compound statement which can be joined by using the connective or. So such a disjunction P or Q is false if and only if both P and Q are false, then only it will be false, otherwise it is always true. Let us see its truth table. Truth table for disjunction. Table for disjunction. Okay, again, we have to consider the two statements P, Q, and finally we have to P disjunction Q. Again, there are four possibilities. P is true, Q is also true. P true, Q true. P is true, but Q is false. P is false, Q is true. P is false, Q is also false. Now, according to definition of disjunction, two statements are false if and only both are false. In first one, both are true, then it must be true. In second one, P is true but Q is false, then it is again true. This disjunction is false if and only both are false. In second one, Q is true, then it is again true. In fourth one, both are false, then it is false, which is from the definition of disjunction. The given statement will be false if and only both P and Q will be false. So there is only one possibility, that is P and Q are false, which is the last one. So P disjunction Q will be false. Now, the third statement will be a conditional. That is, third connective will be conditional connective. Conditional connective, or it is also called as implication. Okay. If two statements are combined using the connective if then it is called conditional or implication. Okay, so if we have a compound statement which is separated by these two words, that is if and they, then such type of statement is called as a conditional or implication connective. That is, it is combined by using the word, that is if and they. Okay. In other words, that is, if P and Q are two statements, then if P then Q is called a disjunction. It is denoted by this symbol P to Q, or P implies Q, and read as and and read as P implies Q, or if P then Q. Okay, so if two statements are combined using the connectivity if P then Q, or if then it is called as a conditional. If we have two statements P and Q, and then if P then Q is called the disjunction, and it is denoted by this symbol P to Q, or P implies Q, and read as P implies Q, or if P then Q. Now the conditional statement P implies Q, P to Q, or it is also denoted by P implies Q, is false only if P is true and Q is false. Otherwise it is true. Okay, so any conditional statement P implies Q is false if and only if P is true and Q is false, then the corresponding connective P to Q is false, otherwise it will be always true. Okay, and in this case here P is called hypothesis. And Q is called conclusion. Okay, so P is called hypothesis and Q is called conclusion in this case. Now we have to see the truth table for conditional statement. Truth table of conditional statement. Okay, now take first one P, second one Q, and last one P to Q, that is P implies Q. Again here there are four possibilities: T, F. Okay, now P to Q. By the definition of conditional statement, a conditional statement P implies Q is true, is false, if and only P is true and Q is false, then only it is false, otherwise it is always true. Here P is true, Q is true, then it must be true. Now in second one, P is true, Q is false, then by definition of conditional statement it is false. Second one, P is F and Q is T, then it is again T. Both are false, then it is again so T F T T. So this will be a conditional statement. Okay. Now the following are also conditional statements P to Q. The conditional statement P implies Q. Okay, first one. P is sufficient for Q. Second one, Q is necessary for P. Third one, P implies Q. Fourth one, Q follows from P. And last one, fifth, is P only if Q. Okay, so the conditional statement is also that is we are using the connectivity if P then Q, that is, or if P then Q chai vaji apan hi use karu shakto. If P is sufficient for Q, Q is necessary for P, P implies Q, Q follows from P, or P only if Q. Okay, if then karun takun hi apan use karu shakto kuta conditional statement. Okay, conditional statement par kai doubt?
No sir.
Now the next will be a biconditional statement. by conditional. By conditional. Okay. If two statements are combined using the connective if and only if then it is called biconditional or double implication. That is, if P and Q are two statements, then P, if and only if Q is called biconditional. And it is denoted by the symbol P implies Q. P, if and only if Q, or there is one more symbol, that is P implies and implied by Q. That is P, if and only if Q. And read as P biconditional Q or P if and only if Q. Okay, so this will be a definition of biconditional. Here we have to use the connective if and only if, and such type of, if we have used the connective if and only if, then such type of connective is called as a biconditional, and it is read as P biconditional Q or P if and only if Q, and it is denoted by these two symbols, that is P implies and implied by Q, and or this symbol. Okay, now the biconditional statement P implies and implied by Q is true if both P and Q have same truth values otherwise it is false. Okay, so if there is a biconditional statement that is P implies and implied by Q, both P and second true false or Q is false. True is also true. True false. false, true, false, false. These are the only four possibilities of these two statements. Now, by the definition of biconditional statement, biconditional statement P implies and implied by Q is T if and only if both have the same truth value. Here both have same truth value is T, therefore it is true. Here P is true but Q is false, then its truth value F. P is F, Q is true, then it is again F. Now again, here P and Q have same truth value, F, F, then it is true. Okay, so biconditional statement P implied and implies by Q says that the given truth value of P by conditional Q has a truth value T if both the statements P and Q have the same truth value, otherwise it is false. Okay, now finally the last one will be a negation. Negation. If actually it is negation of a statement, if P is a statement, P is a any statement then there is another statement which is defined to be true if P is false and it is defined to be false when P is true and it's called negation of P and is denoted by the symbol this negation of P. Okay, if suppose there is one statement P, then there is one another statement which is defined to be true. There is one another statement that is negation of P, which is true if P is false. If P is false, then its negation is true. And if P is true, then its negation is false. Okay, and which is denoted by this symbol. Now let us see its truth table for negation. Here P, negation of P. Now P has two possibilities, it is either true or false. If true, false. Now by the definition of negation, if P is true then its negation is false, and if P is false then its negation is true. So this will be a truth table for the negation. Okay, so these are the five connectives that is we have to study, and we have seen all the definition of five connectives. First will be conjunction, this second will be disjunction. In first one conjunction we have to use the connective, and in second one disjunction, that is we have to use the connective, or third one is the conditional, that is implication, in that we have to use the connective if then. Fourth one is the biconditional, in that we have to use the connective if and only. And fifth one, which is a negation, here we have to use the connective which is negation, that is if P is true then P is true then its negation is false, and if P is false then its negation is true. So these are the five connectives. Okay, now there is one note. Negation of the statement is the statement itself. Okay, that is negation of P is equal to P. Okay, so first we have to, suppose if P is true, that is if P is a statement, then its negation is negation of P. Again, if we take its negation, then it is nothing but negation of P. Okay, and negation of P is nothing but the original statement of P. Okay, so if we take the negation of given statement two times, then we get the original statement. Okay, so these are the five connectives. Now kulal kahi doubt ya madhe?
No sir.